Hi, this is Jitendra Bafna. Today we will going to see how to convert a CSV file into JSON. Okay, so for that we will use a transformation, transform message and the data view transformation. Okay, so I will show you. I have already one CSV file. Let me edit it or open with notepad. So it contains three fields: employee ID, employee name and the salary. Okay, so let me open the AnyPoint Studio. I will call transform message. I will define metadata. I will say add and type ID will be employee, and I will give CSV. It can be anything. I will say create type. Now what type of type, what is the type? It is CSV. What? Yeah, the file contain header. Yes, a file contain headers. I have already shown you it contain header. If it doesn't contain header, then you can remove the checkbox. Either you can define the field here or you can select the sample file. So I have already have a sample file. I will going to select that sample file. This is employee.csv. So you can see employee ID, employee name and the salary, and simply say select. Let me open the file once again because I want to show you like it contain the headers. That's why I checked the it contain header. See employee ID, employee name and the salary, and it contain three records. Okay, let's wait it payloading or it's uploading a metadata. The metadata has been uploaded. It contain three field: employee ID, employee name and the salary. So now I will start writing the data view JSON. The first thing I will write are employees, then I will say payload. Okay, now we have to iterate through all the records. So we will use the map operator and this curly bracket. Fine, let me open the preview also. Let me expand it. Okay, the first thing we have to display employee ID. So how can you face that value? You can say dollar dot, I'm sorry, it's dollar dot employee ID. So you can see it has populated all the employee ID. Second, you want to populate employee name. I will simply say name, dollar dot employee name. Next, you want to populate salary. I will say dollar dot salary. So you can see all the fields has been populated properly. Okay, so in my last tutorial I have already explained what is the map operator. So that's why and why we are using the map operator, because we have to iterate through the all the records and we have to form the output array. So that is what we have done here. Now if you want to filter record, if employee name is, you know, you just want the employee name is Jitendra. So let me do add filter in the front of payload dollar dot. It will give me employee name equals to Jitendra. Let me wait. It's equals to. So now you can see the result has been filtered out. So there are from three records you can see a single record with name Jitendra. Now I will change some filter condition. Instead of equals to, I will say not equal to Jitendra. So now you can see the record, two records, and the Jitendra record has been removed because we have put the filter condition. Now similarly, like instead of, you know, doing this, I will say dollar dot salary greater than 25,000. So there is only one record whose salary is greater than 25,000. I will say less than equal to. So there is a no salary which have a less than equal to, or I will say equal to 25,000. ओके सो दे आर सैलरी, लेट मी चेक एम्प्लॉय डॉट सी एस वी. ओके इट शुड शो द सैलरी विथ 25,000. आई एम श्योर वाई इट्स नॉट कमिंग. यू नीड टू पुट okay now you can see the salary because I have defined that field as a string. Okay so that is how you can convert a CSV file into JSON and okay and you can use the filter operator with that. Okay thanks for watching video.